Hey everyone, Nick Chalant here, the former Chief Software Officer of the Air Force and Space Force, and now the founder of AssAge. Today we're going to be talking about how to use AssAge for software development and also to help you accelerate your software development lifecycle and cybersecurity review. So let's get started. All right, so we have built quite a few plugins when it comes to software development. We have a commenting code module that I use a lot for AssAge to commenting my code. I don't know about you, but I hate doing that myself. So we use it to automatically comment code. We also use it to generate our API documentation as well, is doing a great job at that. We also have this evaluate code here plugin that's not only going to look at cybersecurity issues, but also performance improvements. And that's a great game changer as well. But the one I want to show you today is our automated Git repository analysis. So let's take a look at that. All right. So what the Git repository plugin does is not only going to look at the cybersecurity issues in your code base, but it's also going to look at performance improvements and commenting your code. So it's really way more than, you know, just a static code analysis tool, which by the way is going to miss a lot of the stuff that this capability is going to be able to detect. But more importantly, it's a full remediation audit, and it's also improving your code, which really no product can do. So really, that's a game changer. I've used it, you know, automatically every night with the AssAge code base to continuously improve our code base performance and security. So it's been a great capability for us. So let's take a look at a simple repository, the NIST 853 automation that we open sourced. Just to show you an example here, and we're going to take a second open source repository, a React application, to also compare the results there. But first, let's get started with this Python code. All right, so all we got to do here is put the link to the repository, and I ended with .git. All right, so the first thing I like to do is to check the token consumption here, so we can see how many tokens this is going to take to get it done. So let's run this and see what the process looks like. First, it's going to check the repository, clone it, analyze each file, skip the files that don't make sense. In this case, you know, it's skipping the CSV files and so on, and then it's now looking at the count, and we see that it would only take 1100 tokens for this small repository here. So now what I'm going to do is run it again, and this time I'm going to turn off the check only to be able to actually do the analysis. In this example, I've not put in the link an access token to GitHub that would enable me to automatically create a merge request to be able to then go into Git and see the changes and be able to approve them. We have that capability. All you gotta do is pass your access token at the beginning of the link, HTTPS, and then you put your access token there, you submit, and then it's gonna be able to go through the analysis, give you the code improvements, and then it's gonna also create this merge request in GitHub so you can review the improvements and you can decide or not what to accept. And track the comments. All right, so it did analyze this code and made quite a bunch of recommendations, removing unnecessary import, formatting better the formats, try accept, remove the print statement. And so it's giving you this improved code with better commenting as well for each function. So that's a big improvement there. And then, you know, directly improved all these recommendations. And so now you can either, you know, copy this code here directly from this, or you could decide to use the access token in GitHub to create a merge request in your Git repo. So again, this is not just a security improvement. It would have detected, you know, SQL injections, XSS injections, and so on. So really often much better than what you see with, you know, some of the static code analysis tools. In this case, we decided to use, you know, GPT-3.5. You could also override that and decide to use GPT-4 if you wanted to get even a better set of outcomes. It's a little bit more expensive, right? The tokens in GPT-4 are a little bit more expensive. And of course, it would use it automatically if the token window for this code base needed it. And it would also go to GPT-4 32K if it needed a bigger context window to be able to review this one file. So it's per file, and it's only using the right model based on the size of the file. So it's very small that way. So again, a great set of recommendation. We're going to be actually implementing this into our code base for this open source repository. Now, let's give a shot at another repository. I just picked a random. I don't know this repository. I just picked it, you know, from GitHub. It's a React app. So we're gonna do that now. And let's take a look at how many tokens that is gonna take. So again, it's checking the repository, cloning it, scanning it, each file. So it looks like it will use about 10,000 token of GPT-3.5 and 2,600 token of GPT-4. All right, so let's run it now with off so we can get the code improvements. So it's going to scan each file, it's going to analyze each file, and it's going to do a query per file using the right model to be able to get a response. And so all we got to do now is wait. So also what's very interesting, right, when it comes to using it for software development, you know, we have used Sage obviously to build Sage itself, but 90% of the UI, 90% of the backend, all of the API documentation, all of the API itself, 100% for the DevSecOps, Kubernetes YAML and GitHub Actions, you know, all entire CI/CD pipeline, all of cyber documentation. So really, you know, it's a game changer when it comes to coding, building features. Effectively, you become almost like an orchestrator, right? Asking the bot the right things to do and achieve based on your different backlog. So for us, you know, we are sizing the backlog features. We have a pretty long list of features brought to us by you guys. So if you have obviously any ideas on how to improve it, you know, join us on Discord or send us an email at support@sage.ai so we can add, you know, a feature request into our backlog. And Sage will be probably the one, you know, coding it for us. It's a game changer. We find that on average, the velocity of a developer goes between 10 to 35x. You know, it's really insane. And so one person into, you know, turning into 35. So again, you know, where we also see a ton of value beside, you know, commenting code, evaluating it, and generating it is, of course, the cyber review and assessment of the quality of the code. And then, of course, having this ability to use this Git repo plugin to create merge requests for us every night so we can just review and decide to accept or not the changes. Of course, you're going to see some opinionated changes there from the bot, you know, that you may or may not like, so you could decide to skip that. But, you know, when it comes to real improvements and real security issues, it's doing a very good job as well. All right, this completed, took, you know, a little bit under 8 minutes. But again, you know, if you look at the changes, again, great value, and I'm not going to go through all this, obviously a lot of code here. You know, we've seen both the security improvements and also performance improvements here, and adding comments in the code base to make it more readable. You know, did a great job both on the HTML, the JavaScript, the React, and of course even the CSS. You know, a lot of great value here, I would say. You know, probably 80% of things were pretty awesome, and no debate. The other stuff might be a little bit opinionated, and you may or may not like it and decide to ignore that. But, you know, 80%+ is really awesome. The value you get here is without a doubt unequaled from any other product you could find. You know, no static analysis, no dynamic analysis could do anything even close to this. So again, as you've seen, this has been a game changer for software development teams and cyber teams, really, to get what is pretty much a remediation audit that not only check the security of the code, but also performance improvement, which really you couldn't do outside of having a bunch of eyes on code, which would cost a fortune. You know, this probably costs, you know, under $1 to run, took, you know, under 10 minutes. And again, you could run that on a daily basis or weekly basis. You know, for us, we do that daily to really look at our entire code base and see what can be improved using merge requests on GitHub. So, you know, if that piqued your interest and you have questions, join us on Discord. You know, we have 500+ people there helping each other really increase their velocity and leverage Sage to improve their performance. And of course, if you have any questions, send us an email at sales@sage.ai. Stay safe, everybody. Speak to you soon.